It's week three, so the third episode on El Capitan, and this week I'm going to give you a sneak peek into some of the anchorages that I visited last summer on Tallulah. Unfortunately, it's still winter here, so can't head out onto the water yet, but hopefully in the next couple weeks I'll be taking the cover off the boat, and then you'll be able to follow along with the long list of projects I have to get ready and get into the water. So let's start with the first anchorage we're going to take a look at is Cedar Springs. Then we'll take a look at Ojibwe Bay and then Hockey Stick. And these are all anchorages that are around the Beausoleil Island area. Okay. Springs, it's an anchorage that I like, especially in the early or the later part of the season. It's really close by, easy to get to, and there's lots of space, so you don't have to worry about anchoring in tight with anyone. It also used to have a really awesome beach, but with the high water levels that we've had in the last couple seasons, unfortunately that's been totally eaten up by the water, completely gone, so it basically just goes right up to the reeds. There's also a cool monument there. You saw my dog sitting on, it's called the Giant's Chair. A lot of people like to go up there and take photos. And it is connected to the Beausoleil Campground, which is good if you have family or friends that are going to meet you out on the water. One slight drawback that I would say to Cedar Springs is it is kind of wide open in an area where a lot of people are passing through a pretty busy channel area. So when you're sitting out there midday on a nice Saturday, you do get bounced around a fair amount from traffic going by. Otherwise, pretty nice anchorage, easy to get to and close to home. Now let's take a look at Ojibwe Bay. That is Ojibwe Bay. So some good things about this anchorage is I like to go to it because it's nice and protected. So I did go a couple times last summer when I was out on my vacation for one, when I knew some kind of iffy weather was going to roll through. I like to slide in there. It's got a big rock face, which is not only really pretty to sit beside, it's also makes it nice and protected in there if the wind picks up. So that's a good thing. You also have great access to some nice walking trails, a fire pit, and a composting toilet if that's something that you need. Some of the downfalls of that anchorage is, especially on weekends, if you can't get out there on, say, a Thursday night, you're not going to get on the dock. It's a small dock and it's very popular, so it can be quite busy, and it is a paid dock, so you do have to pay to stay there. Okay, the last anchorage we'll take a look at is Hockey Stick. sneak peek at Hockey Stick. It's a really cool anchorage. You would never know it's back there without seeing it on the chart or actually being in there before. Once you start heading in there, it's hard to even tell that it goes around the corner, but it's a cool spot and it's actually in the shape of a hockey stick, which is very Canadian. I used to go there a lot as a kid on my family's boat, but haven't been there in a few years, so it was nice to go back. Very calm and quiet in there, which is awesome. You see lots of great wildlife, which I guess could be a good or bad thing. You can see in the pictures we saw a bear cub, which was cool. We've often seen snapping turtles as well, which maybe not so great if you're swimming. A couple drawbacks: it does get very buggy in there, and the water is a little bit more murky than some of the other anchorages. I think probably just because it's not moving as much as some of the other places. So there's a sneak peek at some anchorages that I was at last summer. And that's pretty much it for this week. Thanks again for following along. If you like what you've seen in the videos, make sure you click the subscribe button. That'd be awesome. I will definitely be showing you some more anchorages this summer, as well as some more DIY projects. Here's a little look-see at some other anchorages I'll probably be checking out, and see you next week.